the sound of despair as a Rohingya refugee embraces Turkey's first lady. Emine Erdogan was accompanying Turkish Foreign Minister Mevlut Cavusoglu to the Kutupalong refugee camp to launch an aid program for 50,000 Rohingyas.
I hope the whole world puts this issue on its agenda. This issue must be resolved through humanitarian aid and politics. Such an atrocity in this age is unbelievable, and it's all happening before the eyes of the entire world. We have come here to help and announce the situation here to the international community.
Turkey's foreign minister said Turkey's plans extended beyond the short term.
We will hold a meeting in Astana with the leaders of the Islamic world and a larger meeting in New York. We want to find a permanent and viable solution to the Arakan crisis.
The Kutupalong camp has been around since the 1990s. It's one of two official Rohingya camps, but new makeshift ones are put up every time there's an influx.
This refugee camp and others like it have sprung up since October last year. There are tens of thousands of people living here, and aid agencies tell us that they just can't supply them with enough basic necessities. This is exactly the kind of situation that the Turkish Foreign Minister, Mevlut Cavusoglu, has come to assess.
Cavusoglu has asked Bangladesh to allow all Rohingya escaping Myanmar into the country. And he says Turkey is prepared to foot the bill. But aid agencies say that alone won't solve things.
We need to have put an end to what happened in Myanmar. Then we can curb the influx of refugees here. And we can stop not just giving the humanitarian aid, and can start for the long-term projects here.
Until that happens, the plight of the Rohingyas will remain unchanged. Unwanted in Myanmar and in Bangladesh. Shamim Chowdhury, TRT World, Kutupalong Camp, Southern Bangladesh.